With an update on the Marine team, here's Captain Rob Darling.
Determined that in the late 1990s, the city of Virginia Beach did not have, the fire department did not have a fireboat to respond to any waterborne operations, whether it be a firefighting operations or search and rescue operations throughout the waterways of the city of Virginia Beach. The members of Fire Company 1 on Shore Drive were able to acquire through the Port Authority and the Coast Guard a 21-foot fireboat that was used for a number of years. From then, they moved into a police boat. It was a little bit bigger, a little bit faster, was able to put a fire pump on it. They decided that that would be a better platform for them to use and acquired that boat in the early 2001 timeframe. Then it was in about the mid-2000s, the fire department was able to purchase its first fire boat that was custom built just for the fire department itself. It came from Seattle, Washington. It was a Northwind 33-foot fire boat, all aluminum hull. With twin outboards on it and a 3,000 GPM pump. Throughout 2000, the boat has been used on many operations for search and rescue operations, firefighting operations, mutual aid to the local other cities at this time. The marine operation now has expanded into three different fire stations. It has gone from Station 1 at the City of Virginia Beach to Stations 12 down in SeaTac and then down to Company 6. Down in Creed's fire department has acquired a 41-foot Coast Guard utility boat that has turned around into our newest, one of our newer fire boats itself. The boat is being put into service currently as we speak now. The current fire boat is a 26-foot Grady White that is used center console with a crew of three on board. The Marine Division in the last couple of years has expanded from 12 firefighters on the Marine Division up to 54 now with all three shifts and three separate stations here. So we need a vast diversity of people that can fill a lot of those slots there. 54 people trying to, you know, come up with for marine operations, it's a specialty group there. You kind of have to have somewhat of a background with it. Your experiences will from previous history will help you learn how to operate a boat, how to function on board a vessel with the marine electronics and waterborne operations. We have been able to, throughout the last 2 years, we do a search and rescue forum in Hampton that encompasses over 100 different individuals from police and fire and rescue agencies to do search and rescue operations. We have a week-long shipboard firefighting school that we do in May to get candidates up and ready for fighting fires up on ships or on a vessel itself, whether it be smaller pleasure crafts or up onto the larger ships. We look for candidates that have some type of marine background with them. Those are the easier ones to fit into our slots here that because they have come with a background, some type of boating knowledge, for their training becomes a lot shorter in time frames, from navigation to training to cold water exposures to search and rescue operations.